So, welcome to the Wi-Fi series 79, I think. This will be my last time streaming for probably a few weeks because I'll be overseas, but... Alright. So... Oh, instead of the Steve here, we have the Rob here. Four for oil. See if it pays out in this game one. Wait, let me just change the scroll port a bit. Alright. PS2, huh? I feel like Rob just does what Duck Gun does, but better. So they're both playing that similar sort of same plan, but Rob can definitely find ways to box and get in on Duck Hunt, so this is definitely a Rob matchup, a Rob favor matchup here, but let's see if the Rob pays off your other footstool there to top it off on the top of it. This is, if you found that second side, you could have been dead. But this is my first time actually seeing the Furrow Rob here. So I'm not sure if this is a character he like actually wants to commit to, or something like that. Because I've only seen him on Steve before in the tournaments that he's been in, or sometimes like a random pocket pick like Ganon or something. But that's about it. Seems like he, for most of his bracket, he has gotten Rob. 164 here, and still surviving 176, but this stock is about to pop pretty soon here if Royal can't find a kill on blue. Yeah, 196 here, Crew still cannot find a kill here. No cam setups. Yeah, oh, grabbed him, but the can there, saving Crew's life there, just like how snake grenades function in disadvantage for him. Saving Crew there, and that's the first stock down for Froyo. Oh, this is a lot of percent. Yeah, you're just gonna go high there to get out of the next one. And right now, Peru is the one at very high percent here. Oh, this is death for sure. 80%, huh? Yeah, this match is going relatively slowly, honestly. We're 4 minutes in and both of them still have 2 stocks. But I guess this is the kind of matchup you can imagine with Duck Gun, right? Is this death? Does up air kill here? Oh, if you went for up air, probably wouldn't have killed on Rob, but... Oh, maybe it would, actually. Right. There you go, last stock for Furrow here. And this time, Peru's, what's it called? Percentage is way lower than expected here. Yeah, this is looking a bit out of hand here for what's it called? Yep, for he's dead there to that 4 there. He's playing Duck Hunt, but it feels like Peru is overwhelming for in a way of sorts. Alright, so game 2 here, let's see if he changes up, or is he still going to stick to the Rob here? Ready? my... Okay, there we go. It's working out. Kalos here. There's a bigger stage for Fora to play with here, but... Maybe it's to help with the aggression because Peru is playing this Duck Hunt kind of aggressive fusion. Mm. 148 here on. Wait, I need a. Sorry, I need to deal with something first. All right, there we go. Yeah, sorry, I'm dealing with something right now. Let me... Okay, I'm back, I'm back. Oh, Ferrari didn't believe you. Up air here. Doesn't kill because Rob is heavy, but... Yeah, right now... Ferrari has been surviving to high percents here. And in this game, it's in particular, it's helping a lot. Oh, there you go. That's just stock. There we go. There. That's the game for him there, and they're putting one on the board. Okay, I'm back. Just a view of something related to another set called mods. Okay. on you. It's actually been surprisingly, even though I've run brackets for this long, it's been a long time since I've seen like a like an actual good run. Down throw, he's gonna mash any time. Yeah, alright. Well, throw down an entire stock here. This could be rough. But if he manages to live to 170, he could tie it up. If he gets his kill now or something. Oh, up smash. What was that? Oh god, the Hail Mary side B there. Right now Peru still has not dropped the stock here. Peru's getting a little bit desperate. Another side B. I think this game is pretty much unwinnable. But I mean, if here's Rob, you can. Oh god. This free stock to top it off there. I forgot to change this the entire time. Okay, there we go. There we go. 2-1 in Peru's favor. Okay. Does he change the Steve? No, he just stays Rob. I would like to see a Steve pick. Right? But at the same time, I understand why he doesn't want to, because he's from the same region as Peru and he plays Peru like every other day in bracket. So maybe he wants to try something different here. I mean, it makes sense. He hasn't lost the game. In this entire tournament before meeting Peru, he's won 6 games in a row with Rob, so I don't know, maybe he's just trying out like a new counterpick for Peru exactly, because Peru has beaten them quite a few times here. Alright, match point for Peru here. Let's see how this goes. Just nair on ledge. It works every time. Oh. Dude, then the frame traps with Peru are actually going to work. It's a battlefield, huh? I understand why he would go here. Yeah. Okay. So we're just checking projectiles at each other. Non-stop. The side B saved him. Is he gonna go for? Yeah, he tried to go for an up air after the Tetris reset off the platform of the down air. It seems like Ferrer has been living to like 160, 170% like almost every stock, but like almost doesn't matter for some reason, because the lead is just so big that Ferrer was able to clean it up, even forgetting the hypes. Oh god, that hurt. Thank you. I beat. Oh, if that hit, I could have been 100%. But okay. Frora here closes the stock out. Is the stream laggy for you guys? It's a bit laggy on my end. I don't think it's a game problem. I think it's a stream problem. But if it's fine for you guys, then. Oh, he gets it by the camera. Yeah. If he gets him off stage. Oh, goodness. What did he hit him with? Like the down B? The gunman thing? Last stock. Possibly last stock for Floro in Winners here. You can't find this game here. Oh, yeah, Frora's going for a bit of random stuff on the honestly. This is death? No, he lives. That was a really slow match from Frora out the down throw. Oh god. That was very, I think that was bad DI from Frora there on the upper. I think he DI'd right into the left. There we go. Frora's gonna take that pretty dominantly. They're 3-1. In the one game that Frora won, it looks like he had the upper hand, but in the end, yeah, Peru just took it.